1985, tomorrow, next month, I'll be president of this country. I will be president of this country. I know that.
Elections to Lincoln, I'm passing the plan I'm very well. Elections to Lincoln, I'm passing the plan I'm very well. Him take all politicians, we rule Nigeria before. Disabled politicians, we spoil Nigeria before. I'm passing the carry all of them, all of them, they're there now. Enough of this. The younger figures they get two ears for head, them get two eyes too. Yeah. Them they see the thing where they happen on them, they hear them too. Yeah. Few people they fat with the big money and the rest they hungry. Yeah. Me I challenge your boss or journal, while you're in there, you're the time. Yeah. Make him carry me go any court, I go open book for him. Yeah. Now while your government we dey oh. Help by me, oh, now we give my government we do. Yeah, party, bow, oh, a party, government we do. Help by me, oh, we give money, party, party, arranging it. Why yo, party, party, arranging it. We give money, why yo, Adam together, give me the answer. I mean, arrangement. We give money.
Who is Fela? Some say he's the greatest musician in Africa. Others that he's a prophet. Still others that he's a rebel, a revolutionary tribune. Once his name was Fela Ransom Kuti, the name of a slave. Since 1977, he calls himself Fela Anikulapo Kuti, the name of a king. To support his candidacy in the presidential elections of 1983, he created his own party, the MOP. The movement of the people.
The youth are not interested in election anyway. I think they will be interested if MOP takes part, you know. And it would be wise for them to register MOP quickly, because if they don't register MOP this time, I think there will be trouble. But the point is, knowing this government, they will not register me. They don't intend to register me. They are trying to make the government into a two-party government where they won't be able to register any more parties. They want to make it like a law that no, the government cannot have more than two parties in the country. The people's minds have gone low. Food. No food, no water, no light, no government. So the people are aging. There's no solid situation. The roots have been lost. Our senators are going to America every day and coming back. And nothing is happening in my country. And the newspapers are crying, I'm robbers, thieves. So the public think they have to take care of themselves. So any thief they think they see, they lynch, they kill by themselves, which is wrong. It's very un-African. Africans don't behave like that. These are the kind of criminal behavior, criminal atmosphere a government has put in the country. People not having steady minds. But I see a future. I see a future in my own political party. Pan-Africanism is in the minds of everybody now, subconsciously. Everybody knows they have to be Africans now.
Fela was born in 1938 in Nigeria. His father was a Protestant preacher and a school principal, a severe, rigorous man in the British manner. His mother was the great lady of Nigerian independence, a militant attracted by the communist cause. She even met Mao Zedong. The Ransom Kutis were not inhibited by the English settlers. They were also totally indifferent about upholding the old African traditions. They provided young Fela with a typical Western education. In the early 60s, Fela was a student in London. His love then was music, not politics. In his generation, African consciousness would suffer a strange detour through the Black American movement. The whole black world shared the dream of Martin Luther King. A few months later, Kennedy was assassinated.
This nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream.
In 1969, Fela sails for the United States. He'll stay 10 months. Black power is at its peak after the disappointment of the various civil rights movements, the Watts riots, the assassination of Martin Luther King. In Los Angeles, Fela reads the autobiography of Malcolm X over and over again. He wants to become a hero, a black hero. He writes his first protest songs. Across the ocean, 3,800 miles away from home, Fela discovers Africa. When Fela returns to Nigeria, the Biafra War is raging. It will go on for 2.5 years and leave 1 million dead among the ruins. As wars go, this one is particularly absurd. The division of Africa among the colonialist powers failed to consider ethnic frontiers. The Biafran rebels attempt to secede only to be ruthlessly subdued by federal forces. Fela's mistrust of new African governments, especially that of Nigeria, is born from this war. It's a mistrust that will soon grow into open war.
You know, there are many dangerous people in Africa. The president of Nigeria is dangerous. Shagari is dangerous. As a person himself, he's weak. But his surroundings, his administration is dangerous. He is not as dynamic.